Hi, I'm John Deere, owner of Adorable Ideas, and today we're going to show you a very quick tutorial on how to successfully do freestanding lace. Now, the first thing you should know about freestanding lace is that the design should not be resized, if at all possible. If you resize a lace design, you have the possibility of ruining the integrity of the design so that the stitches are no longer locking together perfectly. And when you dissolve the stabilizer away from the lace, it could actually fall apart in your hand. So try to keep the integrity of the design intact. The next thing is the thread type that you're going to use. Personally, I don't like to use polyester thread if I'm embroidering a freestanding lace design. When you dissolve away the stabilizer, it has a tendency to be a little spongy and wiry, and it doesn't lie flat or remain soft the way a lace design really should. But keep in mind, if you want to put that design directly onto a garment, by all means you can use a polyester thread because the stabilizer isn't going to dissolve away. It actually is stitched directly onto the garment. Now, the thread that I like to use for freestanding lace is rayon. Rayon is not a synthetic thread. When it sews out and you actually dissolve away the stabilizer, those lace pieces are actually nice and soft and sit flat, and they look perfect the way that lace should. Now, the other thing I suggest is to slow your machine speed down. When your machine speed is fast, it actually draws more tension from the bobbin and the top thread. So the faster the machine, the more tension it draws from the top and the bobbin. And that could potentially ruin the integrity of the design so that it no longer stays connected, and again, you risk having the design fall apart after you dissolve away the stabilizer. Now, if you're going to be stitching one of Adorable Ideas' lace designs, you really only need one piece or one layer of the dissolve away stabilizer. The reason why is our designs were actually digitized decades ago for the bridal industry, and they're very soft. They're supposed to be fashion oriented and very soft to the feel, which means they have a low stitch count. Now, I've seen other companies that sell beautiful lace designs, but they might be for making doilies or bowls or table runners, and they're incredibly beautiful, but they can also be very stitch intensive. And it's best to read the directions or instructions from that manufacturer, because some of them will require that you do use more than one layer of stabilizer within their actual products. Now, I'm going to make sure that I hoop my stabilizer as tightly as possible when running lace. I want to make sure that I limit the amount of pulling within the stabilizer. So if I need to take a screwdriver and really tighten up this hoop and make sure that it's in there as securely as possible, you'll want to do that. Otherwise, again, you could risk the lace design potentially falling apart after you dissolve away the stabilizer. Now, we have our design loaded in our machine. We've chosen the right color for it to run, and I am using a pre-wound bobbin on my 10-needle machine. You can either pre-wind your bobbin with the same rayon thread, or you can use a pre-wound, as this is going to be the back of the embroidery anyway. So we're just going to unlock it, press start. I'm going to make sure that the machine is at the lowest speed, and we'll just run this design until it's done. Now that the design is finished stitching, we're just going to cut out our lace motif as close as possible to the edge. And this will allow us to get it out of the hoop. I sometimes like to trim my lace motifs while it's still actually in the embroidery frame. It just makes it easier to actually work with. Now that I have my motif, I might want to get rid of as much of that extra stabilizer as possible. And I can just go around my design and clean it up a little bit. Now that I've trimmed most of my excess stabilizer, I'm going to use warm water and actually get rid of all of that dissolve away stabilizer. Now, normally I would do this underneath of a tap, and I would have very hot water actually flowing over top of my lace motifs. and I'd actually work out all of the stabilizer. And as I mentioned, I could even go the extra steps and put it in very hot water with a little bit of hair conditioner or fabric softener and work out all of that stabilizer that's trapped underneath the stitches. Once that's done, I just let my lace motif dry and I can just pat it down with some terry cloth. Let it dry and then we will be done. Hi, I'm John Deere, owner of Adorable Ideas, and I like to... What am I going to say? Now, I hope this... Don't get that in there. You're going to do a blooper.